Hello, and welcome to the first ever Spring Fever at Home. We've got some great acts for you tonight. But first, I've got a little bit of comedy for you. I've never really been on board with Get Better Soon cards. I get that they're meant to be sentimental, but they just sound so commanding. It doesn't help that they have all these big letters that are capitalized. It sounds like they're shouting at you. Are these people supposed to wait for their card to start healing? Like, a doctor walks into a patient's room and says, "You've been in here for weeks and we haven't seen any recovery." And the patient just replies, "I know, I'm waiting for someone to tell me to get better soon." I guess it's better not to risk it. Start sending your Get Better Soon cards, people. Speaking of sending things, telegrams must have been really hard to use. If you misread a dash as a dot, the whole sentence could change. For instance, the sentence, "I'm going to go eat a carrot," only needs one letter changed to say, "I'm going to go eat a carol." Plus, there's always the possibility that they could pass out while sending it, leading to a broken sentence. What if they were trying to say, "I hate catastrophes," but all you got was, "I hate cat"? Sure, neither sentence seems like it would have come up in a telegram conversation, but sometimes you gotta make stuff up to fit the joke. For our first act, out of the quarantine, a star is born. He may be a teacher, but he's also a singer. Here's Mr. Stevens.
If you look over here, the words will appear when you come.
Tell me something, warriors. Are you happy in this COVID world? Or do you need school? And your teachers who are oh so cool. I need class. And all the good times we had in the classroom. And hall. Your friends miss you, and so do we. Tell me something, warriors. Are you surviving your time at home? Or do you need school? And all the structure we provide for you. I need class. And all the good times we had in the classroom. And halls. Your friends miss you and so do we. Mrs. Swafford and Mr. Big Heels. Even Mr. Hobby, too. I miss school. I need to learn. I miss Scrims real soon. In the halls. We miss you.
Boom, done.
I don't usually read the newspaper, but I picked one up the other day. Now, they must have stopped caring about censorship since everyone switched to online, because as I was looking through the ads, I noticed some pretty weird things. You'll see this first one. Right here, we've got some wonderful looking tubs, but if you look under the big one, you can see it says, "Perfect for holding the candy you stole from your little brother." Now that's just plain mean. On this page, we've got advertisements for items to make a Mexican dinner. But then, if you look under the salsa, it says, "Find it in the beauty aisle next to the hair gel." That's a pretty strange place to keep it. Last, we have some cooking products. And if you look closely, right next to the air fryer, it says, "We'll leave your family saying, it's so crispy, I can't even taste the squirrel." Anyways, you'll find this next act from Damien Fletcher to be super funny.
In times like these, it's nice to focus on other happy little things in life. So, instead of doing a skit like I originally planned, I'm going to tell you some of the best jokes ever. I know these are good jokes, because over the summer last year, I went to a leadership conference and found that everyone there seemed to love them. So if people I just met are willing to laugh at these jokes, I know that my home school will definitely find these funny. So here to help me tell these jokes is a friend I made there. He is a future leader and hero of tomorrow. Please give up for my friend, Hobie Man. Hello, it's me, Hobie Man. Here to empower, lead, and excel with you all. In case anyone was wondering, I named after the Youth Leadership Conference where Damien went to this last summer to tell these amazing jokes. So, without further ado, let's get started. What do you call Batman when he skips church? Christian Bale. If you didn't find that funny, well, I fear that it's too late to bail myself out now. On to the next joke. What does Peter Parker say he does for a living? He's a web designer. Ho ho ho. Speaking of Spider-Man, or Peter Parker, depending on how you like to call him, what did Iron Man say to Spider-Man? Don't bug me. I can just feel the cringe that everyone just got. Don't worry, the jokes get better. What is a superhero's favorite part of the joke? The punchline. If that's not cringy, then I don't know what is. Last joke, then I promise we'll get on to the real good talent. What did the villain say when the Flash defeated him? Well, that was shocking. Well, that's all the jokes I have for you today. Thank you for having me. I find that all of you are outstanding, in case you don't want to spell outstanding. Thank you.
The court is now in concession.
Popcorn, get your popcorn for the next act. The next act of Connor and Gavin Ford playing Under Control. What is this accent?
Enjoy the act.
I don't want to waste your time. I don't want to waste your time. I just want to say, I've got to say, we worked hard, darling. We don't have no control. I don't want to do it your way. I don't want to do it your way. I don't. Don't want to know. I don't wanna change your mind. I don't wanna change the world. I just wanna watch it go by. I just wanna watch you go by. We were young.
People have been trying to find ways to spend their time lately. I personally have been using my time in solitude to channel my emotions by writing haikus. I hope you'll enjoy this one. Quarantine's boring. I've been stuck inside too long. Somebody save me. Haikus are a wonderful form of art, and speaking of art, here is your next act. Aubrey Acre showing art. Hope you all enjoy. See you there. I was busy watching these amazing acts. And speaking of amazing acts, this next performer is an original artist whose latest EP is on Spotify and other major streaming services. You may also know him as Dean Coffinbarger. Here's Comix singing Memory Lane.
Look at that kid standing there, wondering how the heck he's gonna get out of here. Look at that kid standing there, like his pants pulled down in his underwear. And sure, he's pathetic, he's a dork, he's a guy who can't rhyme. And even he can manage the typical advantages a kid like him could get from stealing that lyric.
Wish we could turn back time.
Oh sure, we can, da memory lane. You're skipping down, looking round, feeling like a ghost town. Spitting out these verses, feeling memories cursing. The day you dared to remember them. Like a bike gang that never stops, tracking down one guy to make sure his mug gets shot. If Peter Piper picked his little pickle peppers and got arrested by the FDA for being out of license. Or if the floor was lava and it rises every day, taking every single person to their early grave. Sounds to me like a typical romp down a little old place I'd like to call Memory Lane. Memory Lane, Memory Lane.
Don't look back.
Memory Lane, Memory Lane, Memory Lane.
Don't look back.
Suddenly that's weird. And sure, she's pathetic, she's a dork, and she can't even realize who she wants to be anymore. Why is everything in this blasted universe so complicated, making everyone feel like their life has been degraded? Reality isn't even possible. Typical romp down a little old place I'd like to call Memory Lane. Memory Lane, Memory Lane.
Don't look back.
Memory Lane, Memory Lane, Memory Lane.
Don't look back.
Memory Lane, Memory Lane, Memory Lane.
Don't look back.
Memory Lane, Memory Lane, Memory Lane. I can't believe I just did that. Live. Kind of. Other than the backing track, I did it with piano though. Look at me go! Oh yeah. Cool.
Well, that's our show. Everyone watching at home, please give a big round of applause to all the people who helped make this happen. Aubrey Akers, Damian Fletcher, Gavin Ford, Dean Koffenbarger, Connor Tassif, Mrs. Bogus, Mrs. Perks, and Mr. Stevens. We hope you enjoyed it and thank you for watching. Stay safe!